Well, this is a Friday, and it's sometime after 3 p.m. There's the stadium over there, Stade de France, for which we're still paying. And the ground is so toxic there that grass wouldn't even grow in it. So they had to take all the dirt away and scrub it and haul it all back. That's the beginning of La Plaine, which is the world's first industrial zone. And they still find bombs there from both World War I and World War II. They found one from World War I around my town some 10 years ago or something. And it was alive, man, and it was big. It was just buried in somebody's backyard. It had been dropped, and covered up, and I don't know. So I did get out. I'm not well, so I saved my three errands for today and had to keep phoning places to make sure the stuff was ready. And I thought I'd kill three birds with six stones kind of thing. My husband says kill two birds with one bird with two stones. He does a lot of plays on English. He says, it stinks of high heaven. You know, he knows it's wrong, but he thinks it's funny to get it a little off because it's more, perhaps, applicable and funny. He hasn't been talking to me for weeks. He doesn't even say goodbye when he leaves now. I have no idea where he is or where he's going. See, all of this, this is Port de Paris in Saint-Denis, and all of this is... Well, there's major construction, but I moved to Saint-Denis in 1994, and Port de Paris is completely different since then, and there are always works here. I think they're putting in a tramway here, lots and lots of new buildings. It's just never-ending, and you never know where the bus stop is, or... I'm having to walk a little bit out of my way because the big port area, I don't know what you call it, the carrefour, whatever, the roundabout. No, it's huge. It's not really a plaza. They're just always working on it and changing it. Do you hear that construction? And so, just have to give yourself extra time. And I've missed bus stops. I haven't been able to find the bus. You know, the metro is still here, but how to get to it, you know, like if I wanted that now, I would be walking not the way I used to walk. So, that's just Saint-Denis, you know. Growing. Oof. I have to walk really careful. I'm afraid I'm going to fall again. I have to go pick up my new bank card. It's finally ready. This is the first time I ever lost my debit card. And I'm pretty sure I just lost it. I don't think it was stolen. Probably my fault. And the spouse is furious with me. Furious. But in 21 years of marriage, to lose your bank card once? God. I mean, there were no charges applied to it. I reported it immediately. I did all the paperwork and everything necessary. Wow. Whew. He lost all of his papers once when we were on vacation in 2011. They fell outside the Dinkmobile in Beaulieu-sur-Dordogne. On the last late afternoon that we were there, on a Friday, and I came out of the little house we rented, and a crabby-looking neighbor in his car stopped and said, "Did you lose your papers?" I said, "It could be." And he said something like, "Are you from Saint-Denis or something?" And I said, "Yeah, that's where we live." And he said, I just turned them in at City Hall." I said, "Oh, thank you." So I went and told my husband, and we went over to the City Hall, which was right on the square we were at. And thank God we got there on time, because, oh God, how do I cross? Okay. Because, you know, they were going to close. And I don't think that village hall was going to open the next day. And we would have had to go back to Saint-Denis in our car without a driver's license, insurance, stuff like that that he had in there, which is not legal. You know, you can't do that. So, it's, you know, he has a really short, short memory. Typical Pisces. And he's a triple Pisces. It's really frustrating. I also lost my carte vitale, which is the second time that I've ever done that, but that's my health card. But again, I reported it immediately as probably just lost, and I'm still waiting for the new one, but I'm doing